Imagine Earth visited by creatures from an electric world. Beings created by electricity, who live by electricity, who feed on pure power, who by their very makeup are able to harness and shape electricity, to use it to defend and attack. This is the stuff of science fiction. At least, it was. Until NASA makes an extraordinary discovery among the dunes of Titan.
What monster could move these mountains of sand?
June 30th, 2004. NASA's Cassini probe goes into orbit around Saturn. It is the first spacecraft to do so. And beyond that, the first to study closely the planet's largest moon, the remarkable and mysterious Titan.
Of all the worlds in the solar system, Titan is actually the one that is arguably the most like Earth.
You've got mountains, you've got rivers, you've got oceans, you've got clouds.
But in other respects, Titan is quite different than Earth.
It's something like minus 250 degrees. You'd freeze to death.
This frozen world is a terrifying place.
There's no oxygen in the atmosphere. It's all methane and nitrogen and even molecules that could be toxic to us.
Titan would be hell for humans, but a perfect home for another very different kind of creature.
It's got all the ingredients for life, but not as we know it.
In 2004, NASA's Cassini spacecraft reaches Titan and maps a vast desert of what looks like sand dunes around the equator. These dunes are as tall as the Statue of Liberty.
Earth's dunes are made out of sand, out of silica, out of ground down rock, but Titan's are made out of frozen hydrocarbons and other organic molecules.
The dunes seem alive. What's more, they're pointing in a direction that defies logic.
When scientists looked at the shape of the dunes from Cassini, we noticed that, hey, you know, the dunes are all pointing in one direction. They're moving from the west to the east across Titan. But when we talked to the atmospheric modelers, they said, no, the atmosphere of Titan is moving from the east to the west.
So how is it possible that you have these giant dunes facing the opposite direction that the wind is blowing? It just doesn't make sense.
To investigate further, Cassini sends the Huygens landing module to Titan's surface.
Could there be something other than the wind that is acting on these dunes?
Scientists come to an incredible conclusion. The dunes are electric. And this electricity is generated by Titan's super powerful winds.
As the wind blows them around, these grains of frozen hydrocarbons rub up against each other and form an electrostatic charge, like clothes in a dryer. And that electrostatic charge clumps them together and holds their shape even in the face of the wind.
This whole desert is zinging with electricity.
An electric planet, alive with power. Currents licking the surface and permeating the landscape. Electricity explains the dunes, but not the direction of them.
What could drive a massive sand dune back on itself and reverse its natural direction?
Once again, scientists are forced to contemplate something truly amazing.
Is there something living in the sands of Titan that are actually causing the direction that we see happening?
We know from our own Earth science that electric creatures could exist on an electric planet.
Incredible new research on Earth has uncovered a new kind of life form that might be right at home on Titan. These are microbes. They can take electricity in its simplest form and produce that into energy and grow and reproduce.
These microorganisms that we are discovering now can actually eat and breathe electricity directly.
Bacteria that feeds on electricity? Well, that just opens up all kinds of possibilities for life.
The deserts of Titan would be like an all-you-can-eat buffet.
Titan is just a ball of fuel. If you're the right kind of organism, there's a huge amount of energy to be gained from all that stuff.
There are indeed creatures who eat and breathe electricity, but on Titan, they may be far bigger than the tiny electricity-eating microbes found on Earth.
For the scale of landscape engineering that we're seeing here, these creatures have to be massive.
life forms on Earth show the potential for such creatures to evolve. On Earth, we have sandworms. We have creatures that generate electricity. Even creatures that could survive on Titan.
One of the most successful body plans in effect are nematode worms.
Nematode worms are extremophiles, able to survive in the most hostile environments on Earth, such as volcanic deep sea vents.
You can find them living almost everywhere on Earth.
In fact, about 4 out of every 5 creatures on this Earth is a nematode worm.
They are all over the place. You've eaten some today, I guarantee it.
In the atmosphere of Titan, creatures that are tiny on Earth could grow to enormous sizes.
Life on Earth is limited by the forces of gravity. This is why we don't see organisms like a butterfly that gets as big as an eagle, because gravity keeps them smaller.
Titan has a gravity that's about 1/7 the Earth's, and that could potentially allow creatures, if they evolved on Titan, to be bigger than what you would expect on Earth.
You can even imagine that on Titan, that we have something like Frank Herbert's Dune, a famous sci-fi novel and movie where you have these gigantic worm-like creatures that are just marauding through the deserts on their planet. Maybe the same thing's happening on Titan.
What if space debris from some asteroid collision or an infected probe were to carry organic material the short distance from Titan to Earth?
What's the first thing it would go for? Would our power grids be the best buffet that it's ever had?
They would have a voltage smorgasbord and suck all the power out of the Earth's electric system. We would go back to the Dark Ages.
The next NASA craft heading to Titan could be Dragonfly, due to land there in 2034.
Until then, we don't know what might be roaming the sands of Titan.
We cannot tell what electric beings might look like. We can only hope that when Dragonfly arrives, what happens on Titan stays on Titan.